fourth one, 130 degree and 50 degree. We have to find the sum of given angles to identify whether the angles are complementary or supplementary. Then 130 degree plus 50 degree equal to 180 degree. If the sum of two angle measures is 180 degree, then the two angles are said to be supplementary. Therefore, these angles are supplementary angles. 5. 45 degree and 45 degree. We have to find the sum of given angles to identify whether the angles are complementary or supplementary. Then 45 degree plus 45 degree equal to 90 degree. If the sum of two angle measures is 90 degree, then the two angles are said to be complementary. Therefore, these angles are complementary angles. 6. 80 degree and 10 degree. Solution. We have to find the sum of given angles to identify whether the angles are complementary or supplementary. Then 80 degree plus 10 degree equal to 90 degree. If the sum of two angle measures is 90 degree, then the two angles are said to be complementary. Therefore, these angles are complementary angles. Now we'll go for question number 4. Find the angles which is equal to its complement. So, let the measure of the required angle be x degree. We know that the sum of measures of complementary angle pair is 90 degree. Then, x plus x equal to 90 degree. So, 2x equal to 90 degree, x equal to 90 by 2. Therefore, x equal to 45 degree. Hence, the required angle measures is 45 degree. Question number 5. Find the angles which is equal to its supplement. Let the measure of a required angle be x degree. We know that sum of the measures of supplementary angle pair is 180. Then x plus x equal to 180 degree. So 2x equal to 180 degree. X equal to 180 degree divided by 2. Therefore x equal to 90. Hence the required angle measure is 90 degree. Now question number 6. The figure is given to you. In the given figure, angle 1 and angle 2 are the supplementary angles. If angle 1 is decreased, what changes should take place in angle 2 so that both angles still remain supplementary? From the question itself, it is given 1 and 2 are the supplementary angles. If angle 1 is decreased, then angle 2 must be increased by the same value. Hence, this angle pair remains supplementary. Now, question number 7. Can two angles be supplementary if both of them are acute? Supplementary angle is 180 degree. Acute angle is less than 90 degree. So it is not possible. No, if two angles are acute, means less than 90 degree, these two angles cannot be supplementary because their sum will always less than 90 degree. Now next one is an obtuse. No, if two angles are obtuse, means more than 90 degree, the two angles cannot be supplementary because their sum will be always more than 180 degree. Third one, right angle. Both angles will be 90. As two angles are right, means both the measures 90 degree, then two angles can form a supplementary pair. That is 90 degree plus 90 degree equal to 180 degree. Now question number 8. An angle is greater than 45. Is its complementary angle greater than 45 or equal to 45 degree or less than 45 degree? So let us assume the complementary angles be P and Q. We know that sum of the measures of complementary pair is 90 degree. That is P plus Q equal to 90 degree. It is given in the question that P is greater than 45 degree. Adding Q to both the sides, P plus Q is greater than 45 degree plus Q. P plus Q is given 90 degree. So, 90 is greater than 45 plus Q. 90 minus 45 is greater than Q. That is, Q is less than 45 degree. Hence, its complementary angle is less than 45 degree. Now, question number 9. Here, figure is given. In the adjoining figure is given here. Here, marks have... What you have to find, question number 1 is, if is angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. So, angle 1 and angle 2, it is in AOE. AOE, angle 1. So, here, by observing the figure, what we can say, OC is a common arm and O is the common vertex and AO and OE are the non-common arm. Therefore, the answer is S. Angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2. The second one is angle AOC is adjacent to angle AOE. So, is AOC and AOE, AOC and AOE, they are not adjacent because they are having the common vertex and common arm, but they don't have the non-common arms on both sides of the common arm. Now, third one, do COE and EOD form a linear pair? In the figure, COE and COE and EOD are having the common vertex O and the common arm OE, and the common and their non-common arms are OC and OD, and they are on the both sides of the common arm. Therefore, they makes a linear pair. Now, fourth one, are angle BOD and DOE supplementary? By according to the figure, angle BOD and angle BOD and DOA are the supplementary angle. Supplementary, yes, they are having the common vertex, and the O is the common arm. Therefore, OA and OB are the opposite to each other. Therefore, they are supplementary. Now, question 5 is angle 1 vertically opposite to angle 4? Yes, angle 1 and 2 are the vertically opposite, or the forms the intersection of the two straight lines AB and CD. Now, sixth one is, what is the vertically opposite angle of angle 5? The vertically opposite angles is COB. COB is the vertically opposite angle of angle 5 because these two angles are formed by the intersection of two straight lines AB and CD. Now, sixth one. Now, tenth question. Indicate which pair of angles are vertically opposite angles and the linear pair. By observing the figure, we can say that angle 1, angle 1, angle 2, angle vertically opposite angles is for angle 5. By observing the figure, we say that 1 and 4 are the one pair. Next one is angle 5 and angle 2 plus angle 3. They are the vertically opposite angles because these angles are formed by the intersection of two straight lines. Next, linear pair. In linear pair, the opposite angles are angle 1 and angle 5. Then next, two, angle 4 and angle 5. Then angle 1. Then angle 1, linear pair. By observing the figure, we can say that angle 1 and angle 5, angle 5 and angle 4 are having the common vectors, vertex, and also having the non-common arms opposite to each other. Question number 11. In the following figure, is angle 1 adjacent to angle 2? Give reasons. No, these angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent angles because they do not lie on the same vertex, or they don't have the common. Now, question number 12. Find the values of angles X, Y and Z in the each of the following. These two lines are the vertically opposite angles. Angle X is given, angle X equal to 55 degree because X is equal to 55. Then X plus Y equal to 180 degree. They make a linear pair. So, in place of X, we will keep 55 degree. So, 55 plus Y equal to 180. Angle Y equal to 180 degree minus 55. So, angle Y equal to 125. Then, from the figure, Y and Z are equal because they are vertically opposite angles. So, already we formed Y. So, therefore, Z equal to 125 degree. Now, second one is, it is given, now we have to find X, Y, Z. So, angle Z is equal to 40 degree. They are vertically opposite angles. and y plus z makes the linear pair. Angle y plus angle z equal to 180. So z is already known, 40. So y plus 40 equal to 180. So y equal to 180 minus 40, will be getting y equal to 140 degree. Now 40 plus x plus 25 degree equal to 180 degree, that is angles on the straight line is 180. So 65 degree plus x equal to 180. So x equal to 180 degree minus 65, therefore x equal to 115 degree. Now 13th question is the fill in the blanks. If two angles are complementary, then their sum of their measure is 90 degree. If two angles are supplementary, then their sum of their measure is 180 degree. Two angles forming a linear pair are supplementary. If two adjacent angles are supplementary, they form a linear pair. If two lines intersect at a point, then the vertically opposite angles are always equal. If two lines intersect at a point and if one pair of vertically opposite angles are acute angles, then the other pair of vertically opposite angles are obtuse angles. Now question number 14. In the adjoining figure, name the following pairs of angles. So first one is given as angle AOD and BOC. Obtuse vertically opposite angles are angle AOD and BOC. They are the obtuse vertically opposite angles. Second one is adjacent complementary angles. Angle EOA and AOB. EOA and AOB are the adjacent complementary angles. Then A equal supplementary angles. In this angle it is EOB, EOB and EOD, both are the unequal or the equal supplementary angles. The next one is unequal supplementary angles. Angle EOA, EOA and EOB, EOC are the unequal supplementary angles in the given figure. Fifth one is adjacent angles that do not form a linear pair. Angle AOB and AOE, AOE and EOD, and EOD and COD are the adjacent angles that do not form a linear pair.